We do. We have Tandy, who's in the tree licking her paws. And if you look right down below her, she's got her kill. It is a daker. So not a very big meal, but definitely enough to fill her belly. Now I'm trying to work out where Hosanna, not Hosanna, that's not her, her son. Her son is Tumba. Come on now, Taylor. Rookie move there. I don't know if she's gone to go and fetch him just yet, but I've had a look around and I can't quite see any other leopards just yet, but she's up in a beautiful Balanites tree. One of the prettiest trees, I think, to see a cat's in. This actually could. This is only about the second sighting I've ever had of a leopard in a Balanites tree, which is quite nice. And beautiful bark. I love the way that the trunk twists and turns too. It also creates, of course, amazing platforms for these leopards to hoist their kills up into. And that's exactly what she's done over here. So it sounds like she caught it this morning at some point. I don't know how much of it she's fed, or how much of the day she's eaten, sorry. But I think she's about to have a break. The fact that she started grooming herself so vigorously might mean that she's been feeding for a little while. Apparently they popped in here at the beginning of the safari and she wasn't here. The kill was just up the tree, so they thought she may have gone off to go and fetch Tumba. But if you have just joined us, were you in luck today on this Sunday with lions, leopards and all sorts of other creatures? And you can ask us questions, because this is live. This is happening right now. You can hashtag Safari Live. And this is a beautiful leopard by the name of Tandy, as I was saying. See, she's looking around. Maybe she's going to come down the tree for us. What I am going to have to do, though, at some point is when surprise comes past with these guests, I'm going to have to turn my LED light off because it's going to blind them, and I don't want to blind them. You're coming down now, girl. How great is that? She is too. What is your next move going to be, lovely lady? She looks so tiny up in that big tree, don't you think? Here she comes. Look how graceful she is. Wow. She's putting on a show for us tonight. Now she's going to come down the other side. See how she's using the fork in that tree to her advantage? Now watch your footing, girl. Look how quick this is going to happen. So graceful. Wow, beautiful. All I can hear is the guests singing this leopard's praises. I'll put my spotlight on her as she goes past just a little bit. Not on her eyes, though. You don't want to upset her. Even the bright spotlight can be a bit too much. Now she's just gone behind the car. Where she's going that way. She's going away from the kill now, so she's obviously eaten enough. We're gonna let surprise quickly move. Okay, I think he's saying we can maybe move. Let's try and do this quickly. So we're actually in a difficult spot at the moment because there is many warthog burrows and I don't want to collapse and I don't want the car to fall in a warthog burrow. I'm gonna try and anticipate her movements. She's just in here. Craig, do you want to go in infrared? Maybe it will be a bit easier because I'm not going to be able to put the spotlight on her all the time. She's just standing there for the moment. You can just see her moving. It's almost impossible to see what she's doing. She's in that long grass. Can you believe that? I don't know, maybe she's laid down. Should we go forward, Craig? Let's try and find another way in here. Just watch your head on these trees as we go underneath them. I probably need some lights too. We'll see if we can poke our nose around here and see if we can get a better view. Maybe she didn't go off and get Tumba. Maybe she's just done exactly what she's done now. Caught it, slightly exhausted, put it up in the tree for safekeeping. And came and laid down and just rested in the grass. I can't see her at all. Can you see her? Oh, there she is. I see her tail. Oh my goodness, you're right here. What you got here? She's eating something else. Maybe the stomach contents? I'm gonna push. Oh, there's so many warthog burrows here. It's just very tricky. What have I hit? I've got something in front of me. Okay, we're gonna have to do with that. Sorry, Craig, I can't go any more forward. even as I sneeze, she doesn't really mind. Excuse me, sorry. I kicked up so much dust that it all just started tickling my nose quite a bit. Let me see if I can put something on her here. Oh, she's eating the stomach contents now. Well, not the stomach contents entirely. She is eating basically the intestines. Oh my goodness, I apologize. All the sneezes today. So that's what she's doing. So there must be certain minerals and things that are in and around the intestines. Because leopards and lions... I'm so sorry. Excuse me. Hopefully that's the last one. And they always eat them. Now, you're probably thinking, why she resorted to eating that when she's got an entire dacre kill up a tree and she can munch on that? That's why I say there must be something vital inside those intestines that they love, because they always go and eat them. And then there's just all the partially digested grass and other things that the dacre was eating. She's not a big leopard, eh, Craig? She's quite little, don't you think? She's not massive. I think Shadow could actually be bigger than Tundi, if I'm not mistaken. But I wonder when she's going to go and fetch Tumba. I wonder when. She keeps looking around as well. I think she's worried that hyenas might come into the area. Now, Sharon, you're wondering if she could just call for Tumba. Oh, yes, she most certainly could. Tumba's definitely old enough, though, that I don't think she'd be too worried if he came wandering about on his own. She wouldn't be bothered. But I'm trying to think where we have last seen tracks of Tumba, where Tumba was last seen. I don't think it was anywhere near here. Yes. And that? What have we got there? Oh, listen to her crunching on the bone. Now, because dacre are such small antelope, sometimes you will see leopards crunching on the bones. And just as hyenas like to eat bone marrow, if there's an opportunity for a leopard and lion too, they will do exactly the same thing. But their teeth aren't designed like a hyena's teeth, so they don't have as sort of strong a jaws, and they can't normally always crush through all that bone. But she seems to be doing a good job. I'm not sure what part of the dacre that is. You can see her just chewing away there now. Maybe part of the leg? Maybe it's a rib bone? I don't know. I also couldn't see how much of that dacre she'd eaten either. The way it is in the tree, it's sort of hidden. You just got to see the front of the dacre's face, and that was really it. But typically they'll start on the rump, or they'll even open up the belly as she's done here, and she's taken the intestines out. That would have made it much easier for her to carry it up the tree. I'm having such a good laugh now. I'm not laughing at Tundi, I'm laughing at Ali, because I've been labeled as the one that breaks the cars all the time. Isn't that right, Alice? Everyone gives me so much grief about it, but it's funny. Of course, I take it on the chin, and it seems as though Ali I think Ali has broken a steering rod or something, because her steering wheel doesn't seem to be working anymore. I can imagine it just doing 360-degree circles, round and round and round. My goodness, we might have to go on a rescue mission after this as well. But at least we're able to sit here with her for now. Oh, there we go. You know what? Aren't we so lucky to have Connor? I'm just going to sing his praises very quickly. He's rescued me once as we were stranded on the edge of Chitwa Dam. And it seems as though our knight in shining armor, sorry, Craig, you lose that title, is going to Connor again, because he's off to rescue young Ali. And I'm sure Tristan will be very happy about that, at least when he's not here, there's still some young strapping men that are looking after his lass, making sure she's safe. Not a bad place to be broken down with lions, though. I'd totally be using that as my excuse. Oh, sorry, can't come home now. I'll have to spend the rest of the evening with these big cats. would be quite great. It'd be a convenient thing to happen to you if you were in a sighting with lots of pressure. To have something like that break and then not being able to move. I just hope that maybe the lions do move a little bit away from Ellie so that Connor is able to, well, tow her out. But this is so great. I love the sound of the crunching. It's not a sound we always get to hear. The moon is just starting to rise. Now, I want to show you something very quickly. If you look straight through there, look what we can see. The moon. Should we go back to normal? We're going to come out of infrared now because it's look at that color. Isn't that beautiful? Just starting to rise now. That is so cool. Very eerie behind all of those trees too, but the moon is not the star of the show, but I just thought that I'd point it out to you. Hello, girl. Sorry, did I move my feet? I shuffled my feet and then she stared at me. Yeah, we can. I think, what do you think, Craig? We can stay in normal light if you think it's okay, or do you prefer infrared? You make the magic happen, it's your choice. I'll change my light slightly for you. How's that? A little bit better. There we go. Sorry, Alice, can I have that question again from our young friend William? Ah, there we go. Now, William, who is only 8 years old and he's from Oregon, he's one of our young viewers, you're very concerned about Tandy chewing on this bone and you've said, won't those bits of bone cut her mouth, sort of like hard cereal does? In a way, it can. She has to be very careful, but they are careful though. And we're actually talking about this when we had a sighting yesterday with Impala chewing on a bone. And if most of you have dogs at home, I know it's unfortunately happened to one of our dogs. We had an Irish Wolfhound once where she was chewing on a bone and actually got stuck underneath or in her palate. Luckily, we noticed it straight away and we were able to remove it without having to take her to the vet and without her hurting herself. So yes, they do have to be very, very careful. But William, all these animals out here, and particularly the predators, have got much stronger stomach acids than what you and I have. So that does help with digesting the bones. Hyenas have got the greatest stomach acids when it comes to getting or digesting bone. They can actually digest pieces of bone or shards of bone that are up to 7 centimeters in length. That's quite a bit. Now, she won't be able to do that. She'll be just be eating smaller bits, and she might not even be eating as much bone. She's probably just trying to crack it open so she can get all that bone marrow, which is very, very healthy for them. They'd like to eat that. You can hear her chewing. Listen to her. She sounds like my brother eating. Now, hopefully my brother's not watching. Otherwise, he'll send me a horrible message saying, why am I saying that he eats like that? But it's the truth. Anyways, Izzy, you said that she looks so powerful. She does. Even though she might be small in stature, she's definitely proven herself. She's a very good huntress. And hopefully young Tumble will make his return before Mom has eaten everything. Though I don't blame her if she's also slightly selfish and wants to devour this Dacre kill all on her own. But I'm sure Tumble will be here by tomorrow sometime, maybe even later this evening. She's still munching on the intestine. Is that delicious? Craig, how would you feel if Happiness or Amanda served you up some intestines? Would you like that?
No, I'd absolutely love it.
Craig said he'd absolutely love it. And I don't think you'd enjoy it as much as Tundi's enjoying it right now. She's almost looks like she's eating with her eyes closed, too. She looks like she's loving it that much. No, she's still got them open just slightly. How lucky have we been today, though? It's been quite amazing. You know, from not starting off 100%, having a couple of issues with gremlins and things. Well, it seems as though we showed those gremlins today. Well, the animals showed the gremlins, which is quite nice. As you look at her, I'm just scanning around. because I can hear grass moving, and I don't know what it is. Maybe there are some Franklins and things that haven't settled in from the night. You hear that now? Those leaves? That's Tundi. She's scraping them over the stomach content. And that's just to hide the scent. Good girl. Yes, keep doing that. Because the longer you do that, it'll be more difficult for any other predators to find it. You angle this light slightly more. Here we go, that's better. Now, Greek goddess, you're wondering if other leopards would try and steal her kill? Oh, yes, most certainly. They would take this opportunity and take it up and try and take her kill. That would be terrible. Right, Craigie, we have to keep going, but I can't go forward because there's a shrub. And I don't think Connor wants to go on. Got it into reverse. So now I need to try and block this monitor because I can't see anything that's behind me. Sorry, it's going to go a little bit dark just for a moment. I just need a reverse. Craig, what's it looking like on your side? Can I swing? Sorry, just trying to navigate because I think she's going to go up. Hopefully she's going to go up the tree again and I don't want to miss that. So try and get there very quickly. Moon is beautiful. Very pretty. Right. I'm going to send you across to the damsel in distress who is waiting for Connor. Let's go and see how she's doing.